she is.
Is she gonna throw up anymore?
I certainly hope not.
Did Mommy get sick because you made dinner tonight?
No!
Then why was she throwing up?
It's because the new baby in Mommy's tummy. Sometimes new babies can make Mommy not feel so good.
Wally says the new baby's gonna be a puppy.
What?
Can we get a puppy? Please,
Liberty!
You're getting a baby. That's enough.
If we gave away the baby, could we get a puppy instead?
No puppy. It's enough trouble taking care of you knuckleheads. Besides, I'll be dealing with enough poop with the new baby.
I'm telling Mommy you said poop.
Nobody's telling Mommy anything. Come on, kids. Sleep tight.
Story time!
Yay!
What?
Mommy always tells us stories before bed.
Mommy can't tonight. She's sleeping.
Then you can tell us stories.
No, I can't because I'm very tired.
I want a story about a dinosaur.
Me too. I want a story about a princess.
No, listen, I'm only doing one story. And that's it.
Mommy always has one for each of us.
Why does she do that?
Because she loves us.
What did you want a story about again?
A princess.
I think I remember one that Grandma used to read to me. The Princess and the Pea.
The Princess who peed?
I did not say peed, I said pea. Like the vegetable pea, not the pea. The story's called The Princess and the Pea. Now listen up or I won't tell it. Once upon a time, in a kingdom far away, there was a queen.
You're next! On today's schedule, we have many exciting events. First, you open the new Sauerkraut Festival in Krenkel Town, and then we review the new manure factory in Fiddlespotten. You'll have to shake the hand of about 600 people, I'm afraid, but then it'll be time for lunch. So you'll get a 20-minute break before we review the new sewage factory in Krigenbrunnsbotten, Rottenhoek. I beg your pardon, Your Majesty?
You heard me. Bleh. That sounds incredibly boring. In fact, it is exactly the same thing I did yesterday, and the day before that, and the day before that. I am bored, bored, and more bored.
I'm very sorry, Your Majesty, but the people do expect you. You are their queen. You can't disappoint them.
People, Schmeeple, I don't want to do this anymore. I want to do some things that are fun. I want to eat at McDonald's. I want to go snowboarding. I want to go to the casino and play the slots.
What are you saying, Your Majesty?
I'm saying I don't want to be queen. I quit. Let my son take over the kingdom so I can do fun things while he gets all this boring stuff.
But Your Majesty knows full well that your son, the prince, cannot become king until he marries.
Well, he's just going to have to get married. Get him in here right now! Right, Mommy? I'm going to Vegas in the morning. You get to take over the kingdom.
What was that, Mommy? The queen meant to say that she wishes to abdicate the throne so that you may become king and take over the many wonderful and interesting jobs that come along with being king.
But Mommy, you know I can't be king unless I'm married.
Well, you're getting married today, Buster, because if I have to visit one more sewage plant or eat one more sauerkraut, I'm going to scream.
But Mother, I have to marry a princess, and all the princes I know are just icky, and I'm sorry, I can't marry any icky princess.
Not so fast, Mister. I have a little surprise for you.
Her Royal Highness had me round up all of the unmarried princesses and bring them here.
Bring them in, Prime Minister!
Good afternoon, Your Royal Highnesses. Today, one of you will become the bride of our prince and the queen of our fair land.
All right, Junior, pick one out.
Mother, this all seems very much undignified, also extremely creepy.
I'd like to make his leaves at 10 tomorrow morning, so creepy or not, you better get moving.
All right, well, hello, I am Prince Reginald William von Habsburg, the Undercrank and the Fluffernutter the Third. What is your name?
Princess Lalanda.
Tell me, do you like dogs?
No, I'm very allergic.
What about cats?
No, I'm even more allergic to cats.
I see. Well, what about...
I'm allergic to gluten, to soy, to dairy, to trees, plants, and even allergic to my own allergies. Are you wearing aftershave? Because I'm...
allergic to it.
Yeah.
Nice reading.
And what is your name?
Hello, ich bin Princess Panzerschreck.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
Hello, ich bin Princess Panzerschreck.
Don't you speak English?
Nein.
Well, it was so very, very nice to meet the both of you. Well, if you'll just wait outside for a second, I'll have the Prime Minister inform you of the most very difficult decision. Prime Minister, may I have a word with you?
Well, which princess will it be, Your Majesty?
Are you crazy?
But you must get married before I get told and won't be able to do any fun things.
Sorry, Mommy, I can't marry any princess unless I'm in love with her. They'll just have to wait until I go away in the magic.
If I have to wait till he finds the perfect woman, I'll be 95 years old. Prime Minister, you must find my son a princess to marry.
I'm so sorry, Your Majesty. There are just no princesses left.
Excuse me, Your Majesty. I was just cleaning the bathroom when I found this gold piece in there next to the magazines. It must belong to you. Who is this, Prime Minister?
This is the new servant girl, Your Majesty.
But this is 100 Kanga gold piece. Why didn't you keep it? You must be very poor if you're a servant girl.
The money wasn't mine, so it wasn't mine to keep. Have a nice day, your queenship.
Wait right there!
What, Your Majesty? Mindy, Your Majesty.
You are mistaken. You are Princess Mindy, and soon you'll be the queen of this kingdom.
Is the queen feeling okay?
Your Majesty, you're not suggesting what I think you're suggesting.
Well, my son has to marry someone, and this thing over here is at least honest and hardworking.
But she's not a princess.
Princess Minchess, I'm the queen, and if I say she's a princess, she's a princess. Well, Mindy, how would you like to be the queen? Would I have to clean the bathrooms anymore? Absolutely not. Okay, I'm game. What do I gotta do? Marry my son, Prince Reginald. Oh, I've seen him before. He's kind of cute. Is he a nice guy? He's a very, very nice young man.
But Your Majesty, the prince will know that she is not a princess. He'll never consent to marry her.
You've got about 3 minutes to make this girl into a princess. And if my son doesn't believe you, you're going to find a new job.
Yes, Your Majesty. Do you know how to be a princess?
3 minutes ago, I was scrubbing the toilet.
Very well, just listen to me. I will tell you everything you need to know. First, when you walk, walk like you have a stick down your back. Like this. Now you try.
Stranger, you're a real prince of a guy.
mother, I just got the most brilliant idea. She could marry me. Well, Princess Minnie, you must be very tired from your journey. Would you like to go to sleep?
Well, I am pretty tired.
Very well, Prime Minister. May I rule with you?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Whatever you say, Your Majesty.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
Well, the test is to see if a real princess would sleep with canopies under the bed. A real princess wouldn't be able to. I myself will sleep outside of her door to make sure no one would be able to protect. What's the test?
All right. Good night, son.
Good night, but Mother. Tomorrow we will help find out if we are a real princess or not.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
How was your sleep?
Very well. Good morning, everybody. Forgive the bedhead.
How did you sleep?
Oh, just horribly.
What?
Eureka! She passed the test!
What test? What are you talking about?
Well, there's a test to see if you put the peas under the bed, a real princess would be able to sleep through it.
I don't know anything about no test, Your Highness. Just outside of my door. It was like a bear with pneumonia. If you took a warthog and a moose and put them in the blender.
Yes, I get the idea.
But, Your Majesty, I will marry you.
Yes!
Hurrah!
Where's the little Princess Lady? About to become the queen. Where would you like the honeymoon?
We're going to Disney World!
I all live happily ever after. Well, good night, kids. Sleep tight.
And Daddy goes.
I'm hungry. Is there something to eat?
We're not allowed food after bedtime.
We can just go really, really quietly.
Okay, let's go.
How should we open up? Sometimes I go into Mommy and Daddy's room, and if they're still asleep, I stare at him and he wakes up. Oh.
You scream! Why would I scream?
Because you fell asleep.
Sorry, kids. I'm really mean. Story's left.
Archer!
Okay, what did you want it to be about?
We wanted a story about a dinosaur.
There are no bedtime stories about dinosaurs.
That's not fair. She got a story about her dumb old princess.
It wasn't not dumb! Oh.
Young lady, this is a different about a girl who cried dinosaur. Once upon a time, in a faraway village, there was.
We're gonna dance until we come.
joke?
You guys come all the way up that hill for nothing?
No, it's no joke. There really is a dinosaur. He's right there.
Well, he was right there.
And the girl has a screw loose.
Mom, I'm not hurt. I'm telling the truth.
Young lady, you just explain yourself immediately.
I was just sitting here watching the sheep, and it was really, really boring. And the next thing I know, there's a dinosaur here. So I called for help.
And I think you're right. The girl's brain is broken.
Mom, Dad, I'm telling the truth. Why won't you believe me?
Your mom's certainly not telling the truth. What happened is you got bored and decided to play a joke on all of us, fabricating the most preposterous charade.
Well, big lie, too.
I just said that.
Yeah, but these kids in the audience don't understand those big words you use to make yourself sound
smart. I didn't tell a lie!
Yes, you did. I've read this book, I hereby give you an official warning that if you ever disagree upon the terms such as this again, the consequence, the young lady will be dire. Captain may order the village military to turn back to the village.
Attention! Right face. Forward march.
You have been warned. And Mrs. Viewbacker, you guys have slain your child before it is too late.
Oh great, now my child is a juvenile villain.
And got three.
Mom, Dad, I'm telling the truth.
Edna.
Maybe I did just think the whole thing up. Well, that was exciting. I always come to that game. You scared me half to death the last time. You're a dinosaur.
Duh, and you're a person. I don't make a big deal about that.
Where did you come from?
Over in those woods.
What type of dinosaur are you?
A boy, I'm a saurus. Ha! I would love to stay and chat, but it's getting really late. I need to get dinner back to my kids, or they will be getting cranky.
Dinner?
Oh, yeah, about that. I need to eat one of your sheep.
You can't eat my sheep?
Oh, I don't want all of them. Just one will do.
You can't have any of them!
Well, why not?
Because there are sheep, that's why. And I'm a shepherd, and it's my job to protect them from wolves, mountain lions, and thieves, and dinosaurs.
Well, I don't mean to be rude, but I feel that is rather selfish of you. And I will be taking one of your sheep. So, thanks for understanding.
What is it? What's happening? Assume combat formations.
What's
the dinosaur is trying to eat one of the sheep.
Consider yourself grounded as of now.
But the dinosaur, dude, he was just trying to eat her, and he saved her from eating all the sheep.
That's not telling how serious he was to make a false alarm.
But I'm telling the truth. The dinosaur is real!
You think the sheep can talk?
Yeah, the sheep... Well, the dinosaur can talk, so I figured maybe the sheep could tell you that the dinosaur is real?
The dinosaur can talk?
Yes, and he told me where they all live. They all live in the woods over there. Look, if we just go over there, you can see I'm telling the truth.
And you just love for us to go all the way over there so you can have another laugh on us.
As the Honorable Mayor and duly elected Mayor of this village, I hereby give you an official warning that you will report to court tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock for your trial. Captain may order the village militia to turn back to their post.
Militia, prepare to retreat. Ready for retreat. You go to jail, you have to do all the chores around the house. You better get home as soon as you're done watching the sheep so that you have time to mow the lawn before they come and take you away.
Well, that was close. Sure lucky they didn't see me. Although, they sure didn't look very hard.
That's not good. Because of you, I'm in a whole bunch of trouble. They think I'm making you up.
Well, on one hand, it is simply horrible they don't believe you. I mean, especially your parents. But on the other hand, it does mean I won't wind up in the museum. Oh well, I'll just take my dinner and be off.
You can't eat my sheep?
take one anyways.
No! There he is!
Thank you.